स्टूडेंट्स, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस मोल कंसेप्ट एंड मोलिकुलर मास और मोलर मास। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डेफिनेशन ऑफ द मोल, द अमाउंट ऑफ ए सब्सटेंस दैट कंटेन्स द सेम नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स एज देयर आर एटम्स इन एग्जैक्टली 12 ग्राम ऑफ कार्बन 12 आइसोटोप। एज वी डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर, carbon 12 is one of the isotope of carbon. So if we take 12 grams of carbon 12 isotope, then whatever will be the number of particles in this much amount, that same number of particles will be there in one mole. Okay, now how many atoms or particles will come out? This number will be 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23. Now this number is known as Avogadro's number, and we abbreviate is it by capital N. So one mole contains 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 particles. Now what is the relationship between mole and mass? Okay, now see, we have two types of species. One is atomic species means atoms, and another is molecular species means molecules. So for atomic species, if we take one mole of atomic species, then its mass will be equal to its gram atomic mass. Now what is gram atomic mass? We studied atomic mass earlier, which we express as AMU or U. Now if we express that in terms of gram, not in terms of atomic mass unit or unified mass, but if we write small g, then that becomes gram atomic mass. Okay, similarly for molecular species, just like molecules, see this is a molecule and these are all atoms. So for molecules, one mole of a molecular species will have mass equal to its gram molecular mass. Now see, if we take one atom of hydrogen, then its atomic mass will be 1.008 U, or we can write 1.008 AMU, one and the same thing. Now if we take one mole of hydrogen, then its mass will be termed as molar mass, and that will be written as 1.008 gram. Now this is very small part, so we usually write 1 gram and there 1 U. Now if number of atoms are to be checked, then it will be 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 atoms. Similarly for all, this thing is atomic mass. Atomic mass means mass of one atom of an element. Okay, and when we talk about gram atomic mass, or we call it as molar mass, then it is for one mole and we express the units as gram. And if we are taking one mole, then there will be Avogadro number of atoms in that. Similarly for this, it's molecular mass will be 44 U, and if we take one mole of this, then it will be written as 44 gram, and if it is one mole, then its amount, its number will be equal to Avogadro number. Now these are the formulae. Okay, now see, if number of moles are given to us and we are asked what is the mass, we have to calculate what is the mass if we are given with number of moles. Then what we will be doing, see, this much portion represents molar mass, this represents molar mass. Okay, because molar mass has units gram per mole. Okay, so this is written, this whole thing is this, and this represents molar mass. So this is molar mass. Now if we are given a number of moles and we want to find out what is the amount, what is the mass, then what we will do, we will multiply number of moles with gram atomic mass or gram molecular mass, whichever substance it is. So this thing represents molar mass. Okay, now in case we have to calculate number of moles, then if number of moles are to be calculated, then whatever is the amount given, we will divide the amount with molar mass. So this thing is, you can write this like this, 1 by molar mass. So we have to divide given mass with molar mass. Okay, now if we have to calculate number of entities means how many particles are there. Okay, if we are given number of moles and how many particles are present in these number of moles, if this is the question, then what we have to do, we have to multiply number of moles with Avogadro number. Okay, then we will get the number of particles. Now if number of moles are to be calculated from given number of particles, then what we will do, number of particles will be divided by Avogadro number and our answer will be in moles. Okay, so 1 mole is written everywhere, so don't confuse in that. That is for answer, calculation of answer. Now comparative study is there. See, in the left hand side in the A figure, these two things are given, marbles are there, one is red and another is yellow. Now they are having same number, but on the basis of weight they are different. So it means different kind of particles or substances may have different weights, but their number may be same. Similarly, here you can see, here two elements are taken, one is iron and another is sulfur. So if we have to take their same number of particles, which are Avogadro number and which are equal to 1 mole, then how much amount we have to take? We have to take amount equal to their gram atomic masses. Just like for iron we have to take 55.85 gram and for sulfur we have to take 32.07 gram. Okay, now if we take 1 mole of a common substance, if we take 1 mole of common substances, then with examples we can check. Here we have taken 4 substances. One is calcium carbonate, its 1 mole will be equal to 100 gram. This is example chalk is made up of calcium carbonate. This is balloon which is filled with air, so it will have 32 gram weight if it is 1 mole. Similarly, water will have 18.02 gram of water. If we take, then we are taking 1 mole of water. In case of copper, if we have taken 63.55 grams, then it is 1 mole. Now molar mass, you can revise now what molar mass is. The mass of 1 mole of a substance in grams is called a molar mass. Molar mass in grams is numerically equal to atomic mass, molecular mass or formula mass in U. U means unified mass. Okay, numerical values are same, only units are different. Now molar, with one example you can see, molar mass of water is 18.02 gram per mole. Molar mass of glucose is 180 gram per mole. Now molecular mass and molar mass, how they are related? Molecular mass of a compound expressed in U is numerically the same as the mass of 1 mole of the compound expressed in gram. Now let us take one example. In case of water, molecular mass is equal to sum total of the atomic masses of all the atoms. So it comes out to be 18.02 unified mass. If we talk about molar mass, then we have to take in grams. So it comes out to be 18.02 gram. So both are same, only the units are different. Now one important concept, percentage composition. Percentage composition of a compound refers to the amount of various constituent elements present per 100 parts by mass of the substance. It can be calculated from the formula of the compound by using the following relation. And now see how we have to calculate the percentage. See, mass percent of an element. What we will see? We will see the formula first. In formula, how many atoms are present of that particular element? Okay. Whatever is the atomic mass of that particular element, we will put here. Total mass we will put here. And then whatever is the total mass of the compound, that we will put in the denominator. Okay. Then we will multiply by 100. So this will give us the percentage of that particular element. Now see, this is one example. Here you can check. We have to calculate the mass percentage of different elements present in sodium sulfate. Now formula of sodium sulfate is Na2SO4. So first we calculated the molecular mass of Na2SO4. Now this is the formula to be applied. Now suppose I want to calculate the percentage of sodium. Then how many sodium atoms are there? 2. So total mass of sodium in this compound will be 46. So that is divided by molar mass of compound multiplied by 100. It comes out to be 32.4. Similarly, we will calculate for other elements. Now see, for sulfur it will be 22.6% and for oxygen it will be 45.05%. Now we can verify this. Their sum total should be this plus this plus this. It should be equal to 100%. If it is the case, then we have done correct. Okay, now on the basis of this, you have to solve these assignments. Thank you.